Hello friends and welcome to a brand new video of Yantriki. Today we are going to see more technical questions of AMVI. The component of the torque converter that allows multiplication of torque is the turbine. It has different function. It is a power producing device, I will say. And then impeller is a major part of a pump. Then they ask you pump, stator is the right answer here. Then the component of the torque converter that drives the oil is, so driving the oil, again free will, no, stator is not the answer, impeller is going to be the right answer, that drives the oil in a torque converter. So question number 3, the maximum torque multiplication ratio in a torque converter is about, so remember the right answer is 2.5 times 10 to 25, or these are not the answer. Torque multiplication ratio in a torque converter ratio is, the torque multiplication ratio in a torque converter is about 2.5. Then they ask you the component of the torque converter that redirects the flow of oil to the impeller is. So there is a difference in question number 2. In question number 2, they are asking the component of the torque converter that drives the oil. And here they are saying that redirects the flow of oil to the impeller is. So here, turbine is not going to function that thing. This one is not the right answer. In between impeller and stator you have to find out. So obviously impeller is given here already, so impeller cannot be the answer. So right answer will be stator. In a torque converter, maximum torque multiplication occurs at stop, low speed, medium speed, high speed. So low speed and all these speeds, no, they are not right answer. Maximum torque multiplication occurs at stop. Next question, the blades in a torque converter have a shape which is square, round, flat, curved. So square is not the answer, round not the answer, right? The blades in a torque converter have a curved shape. The type of rear axle used on trucks is semi-floating, no, three-quarter floating, not an answer, fully floating. So remember, rear axle used on trucks is fully floating. None of these is not the answer. Then they are asking critical whirling speed of shaft is increased by increasing its length, decreasing its length, decreasing its diameter, none of the above. Decreasing its length is the right answer. Next question, the function of universal joint is to allow the propeller shaft to change length, bend sideways, change inclination, transfer torque at an angle. So universal joint, the function is transferring the torque at a particular angle. The central portion of a propeller shaft is made from a steel shaft, gunmetal, steel tube, cast iron rod. So there can be a confusion. Obviously gunmetal and cast iron rod are not used, but there can be a confusion between steel shaft and steel tube. So right answer will be steel tube and not steel shaft. Next question, a two-piece propeller shaft requires one universal joint, a center support bearing, the shaft to be solid, none of the above is not the answer. Shaft to be solid is not there, a universal joint, no, a center support bearing is required for a two-piece propeller shaft. The inner end of the axle shaft is splined to the sun gear, planet gear, crown wheel, differential cage. So differential cage not the answer, crown wheel not the answer, planet pinion not the answer. So right answer is sun gear. The adjustment for backlash in a differential is provided between crown wheel and the sun gear, sun and the planet gear, crown wheel and the drive pinion, crown wheel and the planet gear. So crown wheel and sun gear is not the answer. Sun gear and planet gear, no. Crown wheel and drive pinion, no. Crown wheel and planet gear is the right answer for this. Hyploid gear require special lubricant because teeth are made up of soft material, no. Teeth are made up of hard material, no. Such gears rotate faster, no. Slide-in action is there between the teeth. Right answer, slide-in action is there between the teeth. The smallest gear inside the differential casing are sun gears, no, side gears, no, ring gear, no, pinion gears is the right answer. The smallest gear inside the Differential casing are the pinion gears. Next question is, when the rear wheels are jacked up and the gears are in neutral, turning one rear wheel forward in a rear drive wheel vehicle will cause the wheel to. So if, let us suppose this is your front axle and this is rear axle, and one of the wheels from the rear axle is moving forward, the whole vehicle, because all other cases the wheels are jacked up and the gear is in neutral, so if this turns in forward direction, the whole vehicle will also move in forward direction, and that is why the other wheels will also turn in forward direction. Next question is, Salisbury type rear axle casing is also known as. So none of this is not the answer. Banjo type casing, not the answer. Three quarter floating, no. Unitized carrier casing and Salisbury type rear axle casing are both same. Remember this. Then they ask you, what is the specific gravity of diesel? So specific gravity is rho of, suppose, diesel divided by rho of standard fluid such as water. So in case you know the density of water is 1000 and density of diesel 850 kg per meter cube, so if you divide, you will find 0.85, and that is the specific gravity of diesel, 0.85. so other answers are wrong. 0.85 is the right answer. So the most popular firing order for 4-cylinder IC engine, I have already made a video for this question. If you have not yet seen, go and watch that video. It's a simple trick where you have to remember this number 32, and then you know that for the first case it will be 1, and then 3 and 4 and 2. So this is going to be your firing order most popular for 4-cylinder IC engine. Next question says, piston rings are made up of carbon steel, no. Phosphor bronze, not an answer. Aluminium, no. Cast iron is the right answer. Piston rings are generally made up of cast iron. Specific gravity for petrol is, so 1, not the answer. 0.82, no. 0.5, no. 0.75. and then they ask you the most popular firing order in 6-cylinder IC engine is. For this question, again we have at number 1 first cylinder, after that we have this 3-6, and then we have 2-4, and the remaining this one 1-5-3-6-2-4. This is going to be your firing order in a 6-cylinder IC engine. So I have covered near about 20-22 questions this time. Most of the questions where explanation is mandatory, I have explained. Generally these questions are one-to-one remembering type questions. If you like the video, subscribe the channel and share it with your friends who are preparing for technical exams. Thank you so much.